To a good number of PBA teams, winning a championship has been a matter of course. Through the years, they have come up with the right chemistry, the exact blending of forces, and the perfect timing of luck, efficiency, and precision to emerge with a PBA championship. For Alaska Milk, it took 6 long years for it all to fall into place, finally. Alaska Milk viewed the 1991 season with an eye on the future. It began to trade today for tomorrow, hoping for a team anchored in youth, yet tempered by the experience and wisdom of a few reliable veterans. 1991 saw the arrival of Nandy Garcia, Peter Aguilar, Nap Hatton, a trio of rookies in first-round pick Alex Araneta, Eugene Kilbane, and the sweet-shooting Ruel Gomez. And of course, there was the celebrated acquisition of 1988 Rookie of the Year, Jojo Lastimosa. These new faces would team up with Alaska veterans Frankie Lim, B-Boy Ravanes, Don Polistico, and the comebacking Paul Alvarez in what was clearly the team of the future. And it was a team that was to be built on some very basic principles. Hustle, hard work, character, defense, and pride. With change comes groping and some missed opportunities.
Alaska bows out with the score at 123 to 117.
Alaska Milk failed to make the cut for the first conference and missed out on one all-important game against Sarsi in the All-Filipino to miss a chance at the finals. But despite the missed opportunities of the first two conferences, it was getting more and more evident that the overall team concept of the new Alaska was beginning to take shape. As expected, Jojo Lastimosa spearheaded the offensive machine, but there was also the steadying presence of veterans Frankie Lim and B-Boy Ravanes. Eugene Kilbane was beginning to show PBA audiences the lightning quickness which made him a star in the PBL. Alex Araneta was clearly the eager student, willing to mix it up with veterans while earning his master's degree in slotmanship. Ruel Gomez was starting to hear his name announced by the Coliseum Barker.
8 seconds on the shot clock. For Gomez, poised for a triple. Makes it!
And Don Polistico was right in the heart of the battles in the shaded area as he refused to be cowed by the veterans and the misguided. And it would all fall into place in the third conference. If there is one PBA conference that has given birth to some nasty and persistent ghosts to Alaska Milk, it is the third conference of 1990. The images of defeat have haunted the team ever since. And it would have to take a convincing triumph in the 1991 third conference to permanently keep the ghosts away. With that in mind and the transformation of the team just about ready to be completed, Alaska Milk boldly eyed the last conference of the year. It was a championship or bust, using defense and pride all the way. Aside from the veterans, one player who wanted to win so badly for Alaska was import Sean Chambers. The PBA has seen very few imports who have opted to allow the team concept to surge forward at the expense of personal glory and statistics. And definitely, Chambers is one guest player who knows that the team comes first in each of his five tours of duty in the PBA. That is why, unless when height regulations force the team to go another route, Sean Chambers has become Alaska's resident import.
Personally, just go out and play a 48 minutes of hard basketball, and hopefully things will turn our way this time. So just play like any other game, though. You can, it's a championship series, so it's going to be intense as it is, but you got to make sure you're playing like any other game.
Sean Chambers was to become the force that would keep the team strong on the floor. From the first day of the third conference, it was crystal clear that Alaska was going to be all business in the third conference. On opening day, it thwarted Pepsi 100-94. Chambers was simply unstoppable as he ran rings around Pepsi's Donald Pettis. He strung together 36 points, with Lastimosa chipping in 18 and Lim 14. And with defense as its battle cry, Alaska set the pace early with an impressive string of four straight wins, including a 126-111 win over Ginebra San Miguel. The expected battle between Chambers and the fiery Wes Matthews took place, but it was to be Chambers' round with an awesome show of 42 points, 11 rebounds, 4 assists, a steal, and a block shot. But more importantly, PBA fans were beginning to see the fruits of the seeds planted by the coaching staff at the top of the year. In this game against the Ginebras, Polistico had 18 points, Gomez 14, Kilban 13, Lastimosa 11, and Nap Hatton 10. While the other teams were grappling with the difficulty of bringing their locals up to par in this import-laden conference, Alaska was finding gems in every seat of its bench. But as life goes in the PBA, each conference is a titanic struggle wherein only the strong survive. Even as Alaska was enjoying the early harvest of its labors, Ginebra San Miguel was having its own drive for the finals, with Pepsi even barging into the semis for the first time, ahead of the five-team cast with an 8-3 card. Ginebra and Alaska were tied at 7-4. If there was going to be an acid test of Alaska's character as a team, it would have to be in the war in the semifinals. Ginebra looked like it was on a roll, maintaining a 7-game winning streak from the Elims to the early part of the semifinals. The Gins had virtually sewn up the first final seat. Alaska was locked in a fierce battle for the second seat with San Miguel Beer and Pepsi. But San Miguel and Pepsi's final dreams were dashed by Spoiler Tivoli, who, despite being knocked out of contention, slew the mighty front-running Dragons. Even as Tivoli was crushing finals dreams with an obsession, Alaska Milk knew that its fate was in its own hands. They knew that to avoid a possible triple tie and a playoff, Alaska had to conquer the San Miguel Beermen. On November 21, San Miguel appeared poised to thwart Alaska's dream of going all the way. In the first half, the Beermen raced to the early lead, maintained it up to the end of the second period, and even threatened to break the game wide open with a 52-42 edge in the third quarter. But it was time to call from deep within every Alaska player's heart to come forth and put the defensive wall on the Beermen. In time, the Beermen's points could only come in trickles, and Alaska was down by only one at the end of the third, 61-60. Yet San Miguel refused to melt under the Alaska defensive pressure, unloading a 9-2 bomb at the top of the fourth to build up an 8-point edge. But then, Alaska firmly tightened the screws on its defense, silencing the Beermen for close to 6 minutes. And it conversely lit up its own scoreboard with a 16-point bomb anchored on Sean Chambers. In the end, Alaska had secured its trip to the finals with a 94-80 win over the Beermen. The stage was set for a battle to the finish between Ginebra and Alaska Milk. As both finalists took 2 weeks off because of the SEA Games break, Alaska fans were quietly hoping that the 1-2 knockout combination would eventually unleash its lethal sting. Yes, the awesome twosome of Giorgio Lastimosa and Paul Alvarez. For Alvarez, nothing would be sweeter than performing extremely well in the finals, then winning it to make up for last year's loss in the finals and the tragedy of his injury. The return of Mr. Excitement was a painstaking process that had Alvarez going to the U.S. for therapy, going through the motions during practice later on, and going through the mental preparation of shaking off the nightmare of the injury. And the coaching staff knew that they had to bring in Alvarez slowly. In fact, Alvarez's return to the PBA was an out-of-town game, away from the dazzle and hoopla of the PBA at the Ultra. And in time, Paul Alvarez was ready to soar with Giorgio Lastimosa in the third conference finals. Ginebra and Alaska Milk have a storied rivalry that brings out the best in both squads. Thus, it was more than fitting that they should meet in the third conference finals. Game one. The two teams were clearly rusty and off sync because of the two-week layoff from actual competition. Scores were low as marksmen from both sides tried to hit their targets. But the themes of the finals were obvious in game one. Two ruggedly defensive teams were on a collision course. Raw emotion was clear in every play. In the end, though, it was Sean Chambers who took charge, igniting a 17-2 blast that gave Alaska the edge in the stretch. And even when Ginebra unleashed its patented endgame rally, Alaska came up with a defensive stop that forced Ginebra to take a poor shot. Alaska took game one, 93-92. Game two. A win by Alaska in the second encounter of the best of five would give them a huge psychological boost that would probably take the fight out of Ginebra. But instead, Alaska got a dose of the medicine it gave out in game one. Tim Cohn's troops looked strong and stable in the third period as they erected a 13-point lead. But as Cohn and his staff knew, Ginebra is no easy prey. And in time, the Gins came roaring back to trim down the edge to six at the end of quarter number three. In the fourth period, Alaska had its head barely above the water when Wes Matthews finally sprang to life with an awesome four-point play.
Pass! Cross a foul!
Matthews! 3 points!
And that's the kind of shot that Matthews was looking for.
And then the Alaska points came in trickles. And then Ginebra unleashed the death blows, winning game two, 107-105. As the PBA world braced itself for a big battle in game three, coach Tim Cohn knew that he needed a breakthrough game from his youthful club. Game three was critical in this short series, and he knew that he had to orchestrate the players well for an unforgettable symphony. And in game three, the only music that was heard was the ball swishing through Alaska's net with reckless abandon. After the usual nip and tuck battle in the first half, Alaska found its range in the third chapter with Paul Alvarez, Frankie Lim, and Ruel Gomez firing away from all angles. Ginebra would not survive the onslaught. In the end, it was a 19-point massacre of Ginebra. And even rookie Eto Navarro, who joined the fray in the end to wrap up the game, took satisfaction in a 2-1 lead in the series. One major accomplishment that Alaska had done so far in the series was taking out Ginebra's fans from the game. And in their hearts, Alaska players knew that they had to sew it all up in game four to keep the Ginebra Legions away from becoming an extra teammate in game five. It had to be done in game four. Ginebra raced to the early lead, but Paul Alvarez would not be stopped as he soared and scored like there was really no tomorrow. Alaska would not relinquish the lead, even when Sonny Jaworski attempted to stretch his bench with rookies Bennett Pallad and JV Gayoso. Loyal Alaska fans knew that their dreams would finally come true. But Tim Cohn knew that even with a 3-point lead, with over a minute left, it was still not the safest of leads. Not against Ginebra. But in the end, all the elements of Alaska pride fell into place. Hustle. Hard work. Defense. Character. All of these were there as the final buzzer sounded. Yes. Alaska had won its first PBA championship. Yes, the ghosts of the third conference last year were busted for good. Yes, all those years of waiting, those years of frustration went down the drain as a new champion was crowned. Yes, finally, Alaska was a champion.
I felt that we had a pretty good chance when we had the lead at halftime. We felt that we were dictating the tempo of the game, and we were, you know, and we were able to keep that lead. We got a little scary when it got to be 93-90. Uh-huh. And we had to come down. Sean hit a big bucket for us. They really gave us the game right there. But, you know, Sonny came out with a lot of new things today that we weren't ready for. And I was really scared. But when we came out strong in the first half and we met their challenge, got a little bit of a lead in the first quarter, I felt we were comfortable again.
I mean, it's unbelievable. You know, that hamstring injury happened, and I was saying to myself, you know, last time we had a bad incident when Paul got hurt, but I'm not going to let these guys down, man, you know. I got hurt, but I couldn't let that stop us from getting to the finals. And once we got to the finals, thank God that they had that two-week break that I got to take my rest from my thigh, and, you know, it was fine. I felt great. And, you know, it makes us feel good, especially when they were predicting that they were going to beat us all the way after that second game, man.
I feel great, Romy. I mean, we're so proud of the guys. They've really come on strong. I'm at a loss for words.
You
guys are beautiful.
After winning a game last Thursday, sabi ko amin to. Kasi bumigay na sila.
Now, also, one thing that was very noticeable, Frankie, sa championship na ito, ano, yung three-point shot mo. Kampante-kampante ka ngayon sa three-point shot mo. Very, very confident with pag nagbitiw ka.
Kailangan eh. Mahigpit ang pangangailangan.
Congratulations, Frankie. Jojo is here. Jojo Lastimosa, you know. This is his first season with this team. So, MVP. Anyway, congratulations, Jojo. First of all, this is your team now. So, generally, what is your impression of this championship? Your first championship also here.
Well, masaya kami. But first, I just want to thank the Lord for bringing us all the way here because nobody really expected us to be here in the championship and we won it. We were the dark horse and I think everybody wants to thank the Lord and the fans also, the management and the coaching staff also.
First of all, I would like to thank the Lord for this victory. Sa mga Alaska fans, maraming salamat po sa inyo. To the management, at the Sean! Thank you!
Okay.
Yes. Ano well, to Eugene Gilbert?
For me, papasalamat ako sa management ng Alaska, kay coach team, kay coach Jot Reyes, at sa mga teammates ko. May trust sila sa akin, pare. Yung taga Cebu, pare, nakuha na to. Yung taga Mabolo.
Taga Wireless.
Okay, Dong, ulisi ko. Itong higanting ito. Halika nga, Dong. Dong, sandali lang, Dong. Kadal, ikaw mabait. Alam ko mabait eh. Kababayan pa kita from the south. Ha? Pero bakit pag sa loob, napakainit ng ulo mo?
Kasi mainit ulo ko si Nibel dahil mainit din sila eh. So, mabait ako sa kaibigan. Binabati ko yung taga-Kalimba.
Well, it's been very nice working with the players, the coaching staff, and especially the Uiteng Sus. I think they deserve a lot of credit for this championship. But more than that, I think we deserve to win ROM. Better prepared. He never played a hell of a series. I'd like to congratulate them, by the way. They were really in there fighting. Could have gone either way. But I guess we were lucky and we trained for it, like I said, and God definitely helped us.
That's true. You were prepared for it. Congratulations.
Thank you, Romy.
All right. Congratulations to the Alaskans here.
For Alaska Milk, its story in the PBA now has a different twist. And if the seeds planted by Tim Cohn, Chot Reyes, Arik Del Rosario, Joaquin Trillo, and team owner Fred Uitengsu continue to bear fruit, then the vision of the future will have been fulfilled. But no matter what the future bears, the Alaska family will always turn back to the third conference of 1991. When, yes, Alaska won a PBA championship. Its first PBA title, finally.